Okay, let's talk about significant figures, multiplication, and division rules. So, after we learn about significant figures and how to assign how many each number has, we have to learn how to incorporate that into doing math and then determining how many significant figures our answer is allowed to have. And so, it's broken up into two rules, and in this video, I'll just be talking about multiplication and division rules, the other rules for addition and subtraction, and that's different. So the first thing we have to learn with all significant figures math is just the generic rule. So for multiplication and division, it's actually the easier rule, and that is whatever number has the least number of sig figs is how many sig figs your answer can have. So in all these problems, we're just going to go through, we're going to assign how many sig figs each individual number has, and then we're going to, at the very end, make sure our answer has that same number of sig figs. And so before we start these examples, I want to also just go over one more rule, and that goes for all sig fig math, and that is math first and then sig figs after. So we're going to do all these problems as if we had never heard of the concept of sig figs, and then we're going to go back at the very end after we have an answer and do some rounding and apply our sig figs then. All right, so let's get started with our example on the left. So if we plug this big multiplication problem into our calculator, we get 264,870.6786. And so now that we have our answer, we have to apply our sig figs. So that means we have to go back and check how many sig figs both our numbers had. And in this problem, it's pretty easy because everything is a non-zero, so everything's going to be a sig fig. Remember that as long as it's 1 through 9, it's not a zero, it's automatically a sig fig. So our 815.991, that'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sig figs. So this has 6 sig figs. And our second number, 324.6, that has 4 sig figs. So now we have our two numbers and how many sig figs we have. We have 6 and 4. So our rule says whatever number has the least number of sig figs is how many sig figs our answer can have. So between 4 and 6, 4 is smaller. So our answer has to have 4 sig figs. So now we have to go ahead and round our answer to 4 sig figs. So that means we're going to start at the left, we always do, and keep the places 1, 2, 3, 4. So we're going to have to round in between 8 and 7 right here. So 7 is big enough that we're going to have to round up. So our final answer will be 264,000, and then our 8 turns into a 9. And now we don't want to leave our answer like this. We don't want to say, okay, now it's 2,000, right? Because we're just rounding at this point to get to the right number of sig figs, and we still have to make sure that our answer has about the same value as our original answer did. And we know that our original answer, this guy with no sig figs, it was in the 200,000 range. And so we need to fill in our final answer with just some spaceholder zeros, and there's not going to be a decimal. Because remember that any zero that's trailing, it's after all the non-zeros, in a number with no decimals, these aren't sig figs. So not sig figs. So this number only has 4 sig figs. If we added a decimal, that wouldn't be true, but we want to have it at 4, so this is what we'll leave it at. So I'm going to box this, and this is our final answer. All right, so let's go to our next example. So we have an easier math problem here, but I want to show you how doing sig fig math can kind of get weird answers. This is a pretty basic times table. 12 times 3 is 36. But now we have to apply sig figs. So 12, again, non-zeros, this is going to have 2 sig figs. And now 3, another non-zero, just has 1 sig fig. And so in this case, 12 times 3 wouldn't be 36, because we have to apply just 1 sig fig for our final answer. And so we can only keep the value in this spot. So that means we actually have to round 36, and it will round up. So when you do sig figs, 12 times 3 is actually 40 with no decimal point. And this will be our final answer. So that just kind of shows you how weird things can get. And then just to remind everybody, we only care about sig figs in science and not math, because these are really measurements. So if we are actually multiplying 12 times 3 in a science, kind of setting, it would mean that our 3 really wasn't very accurate, because whatever we were using to measure that, we only could say, okay, we have 3 things. We wouldn't even know it was 3.1 or 3.2. So that's why this had to be rounded up to 40, because it's a really insecure number. We only have 1 sig fig. All right, so now let's go into the dividing examples. And so it's the exact same rule. It's whatever number has the least number of sig figs is how many sig figs our answer can have. But I wanted to show you guys some variety. These are also both decimals. So if you plug this into your calculator, this would be a really annoying long division problem. You get this, 0.834471. And so now let's go across, and this kind of gives us practice with sig fig zeros. And so in our first number, this zero is not a sig fig because it's a leading zero. So the leading zeros are never sig figs. Both of these fives are non-zeros, so they count. And then our number does have the decimal point, so it means that a trailing zero would be a sig fig. So this number has 3 sig figs. And now our second number, again, we have another leading zero. That doesn't count. And we have a bunch of non-zeros afterwards, so these all count. So this number has 4 sig figs. So whichever one has less, that's going to be 3 in this case. So our answer can only have 3 sig figs. So now when we're rounding, we don't count this 0 because that is not a sig fig. It's not really a place. It's just like how we had the zeros at the end of our 264,900. Those are just space holders that let us know how big the number generally is. This zero before the 0.8 doesn't count as a sig fig. It's just a placeholder saying, hey, this number is less than 1. So that doesn't count as a sig fig spot. So we start right here at this 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, and that's where we have to cut off to round. And so we'll end up with 0.8345 as our final answer. All right, and let's do one more example with a couple more zeros we have to consider. So this is 2002, so both of our twos count, they're not zeros. And then both of these zeros count because they're middle zeros, and middle zeros always count as sig figs. And so this has 4 sig figs, and then our 14.3 is all non-zeros, so that's 3 sig figs. All right, so then we put this into our calculator, and it comes out as 140. And so now we have to make sure that whatever number has the least number of sig figs is how many sig figs your answer can have, and it's actually how many sig figs your answer has to have. And so in this case, our least number is 3, and if we look at this, as how I've written it right now, 140, I actually only have 2 sig figs because this is a trailing zero and there's no decimal point. And we have to make sure that it matches the least, so it matches 3. So that means that we have to draw it like this, actually. 140, and then with a decimal point. Now that we've added that, this is a sig fig, so this would have 3 sig figs total, and that's how many we need for our answer. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. That's really all the sig fig math I have for you today, and I hope that it at least got a little bit easier. Bye!